Hey everyone, welcome back to Xenomom Gaming and another episode in the Minecraft for Parents series. Today we are talking about something that is important to every Minecraft parent: parental controls. Whether your child plays Java Edition, Bedrock Edition, or even Minecraft Dungeons, there are tools that you can use to guide, monitor, and manage your child's experience. Unfortunately, sorting through and understanding all of the tools can be a little confusing, especially if you're new to the game. But don't worry, I'll walk you through it all step by step. To make things a little easier, I'm going to be dividing this information into two separate videos. This one will focus on creating and linking Microsoft accounts, which are required to play Minecraft, as well as the various safety features that are available through the Microsoft Family Dashboard. The next video will look at additional parental controls available through your Xbox profile, something that Microsoft automatically generates when you create an account. It'll also cover various in-game safety features for Java and Bedrock Editions. I know this may sound like gibberish right now, but trust me, you will have a much better understanding of it all at the end of these videos. Let's start with a quick overview. Minecraft exists in a few different versions: Minecraft Java Edition, which is the original PC version; Minecraft Bedrock Edition, which is the version used on Xbox, PlayStation, Nintendo Switch, Windows, and mobile devices. There's also Minecraft Dungeons, playable on PC, console, and Xbox Cloud, as well as Minecraft Legends, an action strategy spinoff with its own multiplayer features, which is available on PC and console. And if you'd like to set up a private multiplayer world, there's also Minecraft Realms, a paid subscription service that lets you safely host and manage private servers for both Java and Bedrock Editions. No matter what version of Minecraft your child is playing, they're going to need a Microsoft account, even if they're on PlayStation or Switch. So that's where we're going to start this video. Here's something to keep in mind. If your child is under 16 in the US or EU, or under 19 in South Korea, they'll have to have what's called a child account. In order for a child account to be managed, it first has to be linked to an adult's Microsoft account. So before you can make any parental setting changes, you have to have a Microsoft account as well. These accounts are free and work across all Microsoft services, including Minecraft, Xbox, and Windows. In fact, there's a really good chance that you already have one. And if you do, go ahead and skip to the next section of this video. If you don't have a Microsoft account, that's where we're going to start. The first thing you're going to want to do is go to account.microsoft.com. The link is in the description, and click Sign In. Since you don't already have an account and can't log in, you're going to click the small blue text that says Create One. Enter your email address and click Next. Microsoft will then verify your email by sending you a 6-digit code. Check your email and enter the numbers provided. You'll then need to add some details. These include selecting a country or region and stating your date of birth. After filling both of those in, click Next. Now add your first and last name. Do note that you can unclick the box that says Microsoft is going to send you information, offers, and tips. I know I always do, so I wanted to mention it. Then click Next. Microsoft will probably offer some faster sign-in options for the future. It's up to you whether you proceed with these or not. Depending on your preference, you'll either click Next to continue setting these up or skip for now. For the purposes of this video, we're going to be skipping for now and going straight to our dashboards. This isn't actually where the parental controls are, but now you're set up with a Microsoft account and good to move on to the next steps. Now let's focus on your child's Microsoft account. The first step is determining whether or not they even have one. I can tell you that if they are playing Minecraft already, then they have to have a Microsoft account. The trick is finding out what email or phone number is associated with that account. Once you have this information, you can skip to the next part of the video. If your child doesn't have a Microsoft account, then you'll need to create one for them. Supposedly, this is something that you can do from your Microsoft dashboard, but I've had zero luck getting it to work. So instead of sending you there to potentially struggle, we're just going to create one like you would create any other account. To do this, make sure you're signed out of your Microsoft account before starting. Then go to account.microsoft.com and click Sign In. Since your child does not have a Microsoft account, you're going to want to click the small blue text that says Create One. Enter your child's email address and click Next. Microsoft will then send a verification code to that address. Once you receive it, enter the code to verify the email. You'll then need to add some details. These include selecting a country or region and stating your child's date of birth. Make sure you enter the date correctly in order to have proper control over the various safety features. After filling that in, click Next. Then add your child's name. Before clicking Next, however, I do recommend unchecking the box that allows Microsoft to send information, tips, and offers. Kids don't need their inboxes filling up with that stuff, and honestly, none of us do. Then click Next. Because your child's date of birth limits them to a child account, parent or guardian consent is required to move forward. As their guardian, you can select the top option and then press Continue. At this point, you'll need to sign in to your Microsoft account. Click Next. It's a little frustrating, but you will probably have to do the email confirmation yet again. Once you enter the code provided, you'll need to give consent for your child to have a Microsoft account. There's a bit of reading here. After you've looked it all over and assuming that you do indeed consent, press the Yes, I agree button. At this point, Microsoft will ask what apps your child is allowed access to. Minecraft is a Microsoft game, but it is possible to use this account to sign into non-Microsoft games as well. Depending on your preferences, check or uncheck the box accordingly. Now Microsoft will finally create your child's account. The confirmation screen that pops up will also include some default safety settings available for review. These allow you to change screen time limits as well as turn activity reporting on or off. There are more setting options on your dashboard though, so once you're satisfied, go ahead and click Family Safety. Since your child's account is new, you'll also be prompted to review a few other settings. These pertain to age rating, web safety, buying options, weekly emails, and activity reports. Read through them and make any changes that you want, then click Done. From here, you can access the various safety features available, but I'll get into this in just a moment. So, what if you and your child both have Microsoft accounts, but they aren't linked? Let's go over this really quickly. Start by going to account.microsoft.com/family. The link is in the description. Click Sign In and complete any verification prompts as directed. If it takes you to your Microsoft 365 Copilot dashboard, you'll need to search for Family Safety and select it from the options provided. You should now be at your Microsoft Family Safety dashboard. To link an account, click Add a Family Member. Here, you'll need to select the role that you want your child to have. In this case, it should be Member, as permissions are going to be based on their age. There's a few ways to send an invitation, including WhatsApp, using a phone number, or an email address that's associated with their account. You'll have to verify that you're not a robot, and then click Invite. Your child will then receive an email through which they or you will need to accept the invitation to complete linking your accounts. Once this is done, simply click on their profile to access security settings. Welcome to your child's Microsoft Security Dashboard. There are several adjustments that you can make from here, including connecting devices, setting daily screen time limits, and turning on or off activity reporting, which allows you to see what they're doing on any added devices. Obviously, everyone has different preferences, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time going into detail about each of these options. Now that you know where to find them, however, you can establish settings that work for you and your family. There are a few things that I do want to note, though. First, there are four separate tabs at the top of the page: Windows, Xbox, Edge, and Mobile. Microsoft allows you to make adjustments to each one of these individually. For example, you can set screen time limits for Windows, but let your child spend as much time as they want playing Xbox. I don't think that's the choice that you'll make, but the option is there if you want it. Also, if you're using Edge as your web browser, you can choose to filter inappropriate websites and searches, as well as block or allow access to certain websites. There's also a spending button at the top of the page. This is definitely worth taking a look at. You can either add money to their account or add a credit card. Just giving them access to the credit card can sound a little scary, but there is a setting that requires your approval before every purchase, so that's there if you want it. And if you do let them shop, you can view all of their purchase history here. In order to access general account settings, you'll need to click Settings at the top of the page. These settings are applied across all of your child's Microsoft-related activities. Here, you're able to set age limits to filter out inappropriate content, block unsafe browsers, require permissions for purchases, and request weekly activity reports. It's just good to know where all of these settings are located. Before we wrap up, I do want to mention one more thing that can make managing all of these settings just a little bit easier: the Microsoft Family Safety app. This app is free and available on both Apple and Android. Simply search for Microsoft Family Safety in your device's App Store. Once installed, you can use it to view and adjust your child's screen time limits, filter web content, enable or disable activity reporting, and even track your child's location, assuming you choose to allow that option. It's optional, but if your child does play Minecraft across multiple devices, it can keep everything consistent in one place. And since it syncs with the account settings that we just covered, it's a convenient tool for checking in and making changes on the go. And that's pretty much what you need to know about your Microsoft Family Safety settings. I know that that was a lot, so thank you for sticking with me. And congratulations for getting through it all. Seriously. Creating and linking Microsoft accounts is not the most glamorous part of Minecraft parenting, but it is really important and sets the foundation for everything that comes next. Now that your Microsoft family is set up and you know where all of the important tools live, you're in a great place to ensure that your child plays more safely and more confidently. In the next video, I'll show you how to use your Xbox profile to fine-tune the various permissions, as well as explore the various in-game options that are available for both Java and Bedrock editions. This is where we will really start customizing your child's Minecraft experience, so I do hope you'll join me for that video too. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe for more of my Minecraft for Parents series. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, happy gaming!